Hi, this is Jonathan from MELBOURNE Aquaponics. In this video, I would like to respond to a question that I receive quite often. The question of the worms. Do you have worms in your aquaponics setup? Is it good to have worms in your aquaponics setup? Let me respond to those two questions. First, yes, I do have worms in my aquaponics setup. And secondly, yes, I think it's a good thing for the aquaponics setup. So as you know, I always say that it's good to have the maximum biodiversity possible in your aquaponics setup. Obviously, there are some animals that are more beneficial than others in an aquaponics setup. And you know that in nature, in general, worms have a very, very important part into the ecosystem, into the nitrogen cycle. You know that in nature, the worms, they are basically, in the field, there are tons of worms. Actually, I think that's one of the animals where the biomass is the heaviest on Earth. And those worms, they just basically eat all the roots of the vegetables, but mainly the dead roots, right? So they don't really have a negative impact on your vegetables. And they basically eat the dead roots, and they're gonna basically put some organic matter that is gonna be way thinner than the roots by themselves. So they help to basically to modify the dead organic matter that you got in your grow beds. So the dead roots, they're gonna help to basically use those dead roots and to break them down in some very small particles that are going to be more available for the bacteria but also for other animals that you can have in your aquaponics setup. So they play a very important role. And in agriculture, in a classic field, they also aerate the field, right? They aerate the structure of the soil. So it's very important in classic agriculture. That's actually, if you got worms in a field in good conditions, in permaculture, for example, we use the worms to really aerate the earth. And basically, that's the aim of the worms. They mix basically the nutrient into the colon of soil. And they break down all the organic matter and they release it available for the other part of the ecosystem. And for the fungus and the bacteria to break it down in even smaller particles and in nitrogen available for the plants. So yes, worms are very beneficial in aquaponics, and I really recommend to have some in your aquaponics setup. You may have some worms coming naturally in your aquaponics setup. It really often happens, especially with the small ones, but you can also add physically some worms that either you buy at the shop or you get in your normal garden. That's what I would recommend. If you can have some from your garden, you put a handful of worms into your aquaponics setup and they're going to develop and they're going to reproduce in the aquaponics setup because they're going to find a beneficial environment for them. They're going to find some food, they're going to find an area, not on the very bottom of the grow bed, but you know, because we have a bell siphon, the water level is going up and down, so they can always breathe, they can live in this environment without any problem, so they don't have any real problem being in contact with a moist environment, and therefore, yeah, in the aquaponics setup, it's perfect for them. In my aquaponics setup, I got two kinds of worms. I got the classic ones that some people call the compost worms. They are long and dark, and yeah, you can use them to feed your fish. And I got the other one as well, some basically whitish worms that are extremely, extremely active. Each time I got a dead leaf or something, they are here and they basically start to degrade the dead particles or the dead organic matters that are into the aquaponics setup. So that's really those two kinds of worms. They are very efficient and I reckon they act at different levels. So, I mean, obviously the largest variety, biodiversity you have and the better it is, So it's really good to have those two kinds of worms in your aquaponic setup. So I am also thinking of using those worms to feed my fish. That's what I already do, but I'm trying to always find new ways to basically attract them, trap them, and being able to put them into the fish tank. Because as you know, the fish are always eating the same kind of fish food pellets. And if you always feed your fish with these kind of fins, after a while the fish may get bored of it. So it's always good if you can add some living food into the fish tank. Obviously, I work with silver perch. So silver perch is a omnivorous fish, and they can be vegetarian when they get bigger. So I can feed them with leaves of the vegetables that I grow. Sometimes I give them the old leaves or the leaves that I don't want to eat. But you can also feed them with the worms. So if you give them some worms, the worms are full of good things for the silver perch. And for any fish, basically, they are full of vitamins and really interesting nutrients. They are live food, so it's basically one of the best things you can give to your fish. So obviously, it's going to be extremely hard to produce a large quantity of worms enough to feed your fish or to only rely on this source of food for your fish. But what you can do is to basically try to trap a few sometimes at times. When you dig into your grow bed and you find some worms, you can just physically take them and put them into your grow bed. It's going to be a fantastic gift for you, for your fish.
So if you have a look at your aquaponic setup during the night, you're going to find a lot of very interesting creatures. All the nocturnal insects are going to be out, but also all the worms. You see those two worms here, they were mating and they were in reproduction. And obviously, as soon as I put the light on them, and they try to hide. But yeah, all the worms, they try to come at the surface to find all the dead leaves that you can have on your media, or even the algae. Anything that is basically a dead organic matter, they are trying to find them and to eat them during the night. So if you have an aquaponic setup and you want to see them, just have a look at your aquaponic setup during the night and you may be able to find some. Here, it was a dead root that was in my aquaponic setup that I just pulled out. And you see that after shaking it into the grow bed for a little while, you see all the little worms that are going out. You see those little white worms that are moving. They were basically eating the dead root, and now they are basically free food for my fish. So I'm just gonna leave this kind of root in the fish tank. I shake it for a little while, so a lot of fish just fall off, and then I leave it into the fish tank, and the fish will be able to eat the worms whenever they want them. So that's a fantastic food for your fish, especially if you breed fish. If you have small fish, you want to feed them with this kind of extra quality food.
If you are watching this video on YouTube, you will see that on the description of the video just below, you will have access to some free gifts. First, you have access to a six-step process to be able to build your own aquaponic system in good conditions. I developed this six-step process because I found that too many beginners are basically starting aquaponics with a wrong design. So if you want to build your own aquaponic setup, please just follow this six-step process. It's completely free, right? I redesigned it to help you to build your setup in good conditions and therefore to succeed in aquaponics. The second gift is for people who already have aquaponics. A very common problem we have in aquaponics is that we got the leaves of the vegetables that are turning yellow. And the reason why is because basically in aquaponics we sometimes need to add some minerals, otherwise the vegetables have some deficiencies. So if you have this problem, I made a special video about it as well, and you can have access to it in the description of the video. It's the free bonus video. If you are very interested into aquaponics, you can also have access to a webinar, a free webinar specific to aquaponics. I deliver a lot of information. Finally, you are probably aware that I wrote a digital aquaponics manual called The Art of Aquaponics, and you can have access to a free excerpt of this aquaponics manual where I add a lot of value and I give you a lot of my knowledge about aquaponics. So don't forget that you can have access to those four gifts on the description of the video, and I'm sure they're going to help you to develop your aquaponic setup and to produce your own sustainable and healthy food in good conditions. Bye bye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!